Taking a short break from yesterday's intense budget session, the Chief Minister made his way across the border into La Linea. On the Spanish side, he was met by the mayor, Juan Franco. And in a display of friendship, the two made their way to the statue that pays tribute to cross-border workers to close commemorations of the 50th anniversary of the border closure. Surrounded by reporters from both sides of the border, both men emphasised the closure as a negative and traumatic event and spoke of the consequences and impact on the lives of both communities and, more importantly, families and individuals. Juan Franco said that his town's population almost halved after the border closed and that La Linea lost its jovial character. The Chief Minister, for his part, said the closure helped to cement Gibraltarian identity and that Gibraltar became stronger.
When the gates clanged closed, we had a deficit of £352,000 and they were going to ruin us and we were going to fall like a ripe fruit. 50 years later, we have a record surplus of £85 million. We're more prosperous than we've ever been. We're not ever going to fall.
Contrasting with a display of friendship were the comments made this weekend by an important Spanish businessman. Miguel Rodriguez is the owner of the international Festina Watchmaker Group. He was born in La Linea, but left when the border closed. In an interview with the Spanish press on the day of the 50th anniversary, Rodriguez said that over the decades, Spanish politicians have allowed themselves to be humiliated over the issue of Gibraltar. He attributed the drugs trafficking issue in the Campo area to Gibraltar and also accused the ROC of living off Spain, calling Gibraltar a cancer.
Look, anybody who reads something like that, in particular at a time like this when we're seeing the effect, we're remembering the effect of the division that was brought by Franco, and we know what cancer means in Gibraltar. Cancer's affected every family in Gibraltar, just like the frontier closer affected every family in Gibraltar. And this man sells watches. I think he still thinks it's 1969. I wouldn't buy a watch off him.
And with the 50th anniversary of the closure now marked, the two leaders on either side of the border promised to maintain and promote good relations and friendship, whatever challenges the future might bring.